I like to show you how to binarize the production rules of a grammar in order to produce a Chomsky normal form. What binarizing means is that you only have rules non-terminals that looks like this. One non-terminal is on the left side, and two non-terminals are on the right side, and it shall be exactly two non-terminals on the right side and not more and not less than two. And if you didn't do it yet, you want to exchange the terminals by non-terminal rules. So I add two new rules. A goes to A, B goes to B, and I exchange those non-terminals in that rule. So I get a new S production with A, B, A, A, B. And as you can see, those production rules, after some derivations, will give me the exact same string as this rule does. So I cross that out. And that means that if you binarize a rule, you will take more derivations to produce the same word as if you would have rules with longer right-hand sides. So now you can basically choose how to go on, and I like to do it from left to right. So I will choose a separation, and I will create a non-terminal for any part that is longer than I want to. I could choose a separation here, but I could also do a separation here. I show you what I mean. Now in order to make this rule a rule with two non-terminals on the right side, I want to exchange all what is after the A by another non-terminal. I name it, for example, I name it X1 or something. It doesn't matter, it could be C or anything. And this goes to B, A, A, B. And now I take this rule out, and it gives me another rule where I keep those A here, and I exchanged this part by those new non-terminal I produced. So now what you see here, I had a production rule with five non-terminals on the right side, and now I have a new production rule with only four on the right side. And I will go on and do the same over and over again until all of the rules only have two non-terminals on the right side. So now I will take again everything that's after this B and add a new non-terminal. I name it X2. This goes to AAB. And now I take this rule out and add another one for it. Now I want a new where X1 goes to B and X2. And now my longest rule has three non-terminals on the right side. I have to do it one more time. I choose this part and I add another non-terminal, X3, that goes to A and B. And I take this rule out and add another one for those I crossed out, that goes to A and X2. And if you are smart, you could choose separations so that that you maybe need less rules. For example, you could have one rule from a non-terminal that produces A and B, and you could exchange this part by it and this part by it, and so you can find ways where you don't need as many rules as maybe as I did now. And now what we did at the end, At the beginning, we only had, if we want to make a derivation and create this word, we would have a tree that looks like this. So S goes to A, B, A, A, B. And if we now want to produce the same word, we get another tree that looks like this. We now have a new S rule that goes to A and X1, and those A will go to a small a. X1 goes to B and X2, and X2 goes to, oh, I made a mistake. This has to be X3 and not X2 again. So X2 and X3, and X3 goes to A and B. And if you did everything right, then your new grammar should create all the same words that your old grammar produced.